certain thing, in so many words, is an incarceration. Now, another thing happened in this dispensation of time. In this dispensation of time, when a lot of people are dying now, they have found out that that particular realm, that light that used to snatch them back down, he is very weak. And it does not snatch the memory away, and they are able to not reincarnate now. A lot of them are going to the underworld plane. So you got different planes. The Egyptians tells you to go to the underworld. That's where Osiris is. The Osirian realm is different than the astral realm. You got two realms. There is the astral plane, which is nothing but a form of the matrix. And all you see, then you have the underworld realm, which is where the most ancient souls go. If you have enough knowledge to get there. Before, you had to have enough knowledge to get to that particular land of Osiris, the kingdom of Osiris. Now what is happening here is the astral plane, which is the world that is leaving. Just like you got the physical world here that we say is leaving, the astral world is also comprised of that same matrix. And it is leaving, so it's very weak. So a lot of the ones that used to reincarnate is not reincarnating anymore. Anymore. Now, to ask this other question about what it has to do with race, it has a lot to do with race. You know how you take a computer and you mash a button, and if you mash the P, it comes up on the screen, the P. You mash the R and it comes up the R, or you type in something and you get what you want. Well, that's the way it is when it comes, because what we're talking about here is we're talking about the whole astral plane and the underworld, and everything we deal with is comprised of nothing but alchemical energy. It's all it is. The physical is only an illusion. It's only based on energy. And the energy goes where the energy has to go. That's why, in that case, why we don't reincarnate white. Right out of the black bag. Why is it it's the same system? You see what I'm saying? Like that. Why is it you don't have, other than the genetic thing, you got to have some white people born? Why is it the white people that's white now? If they are a mutant, why the hell in the next child that come, why ain't it black? That's because there's an alchemical line. It talks about it in the Gnostic aspect. They say that the soul has a shadow with it. And whatever that shadow is, and the shadow means melon. If it has that shadow, then what happens is, it's going to reincarnate into the shadow conductors that bring forth shadow energy. And not necessarily in mutant energy. See, this thing, it in just general metaphysics, it can get kind of confusing. But when you really study the advanced aspect of it, then you understand that certain energies go where certain energies go, just like certain energies don't go where certain energies go. It's just like an energy that is not, if you got a door crack, and energy that is not light cannot get through the door. But energy that is light will find its way to get through the door. Energy that is water can find its way to get through the door. But energy that is bricks ain't coming through that door. You see what I'm saying? Well, it's the same way on these particular fields. There are those particular ones that got souls or energy frequencies, and they always go with the conductors that have souls. And the other ones go with other things. And to give you an example. So, one guy went over to the astral plane back in 93. Brother in Atlanta went to the astral plane. He said it was a room full of white people. He was astral traveling. He said, then, he said, goddamn, what the hell going on? And one night, he said, then, a black figure stepped through the room, like appeared through the white people, which was an illusion, and grabbed him and took him into a room full of black people. You see what I'm saying? So, it's a matter of the alchemical energy on where those souls go, but they never go off track. Now, in the white area, you can have ancient souls incarnate into white bodies because it's only dealing with the shell. So you just have a few of those, like 2%. But you can't have a lesser energy incarnating into a higher power conductor. You see what I'm saying? Into a higher power conductor. You see what I'm saying? We are all trapped into a physical. So it's a lot of... It's a lot of things, but you have to. What happens here is the reason why I can explain these particular things here is because I was faced with the same answers, and the process of me speaking was that I didn't get into this to speak. The people told me I needed to be speaking, and they actually made me speak. gimmick that you got. And you don't have to go beyond that. That's what a lot of people do. It's ego. They will go, they will just, they come out 1 or 2 years, they get a standing, and they get that gimmick going, and they get, just keep it going. And they don't want to go to further research because it means that they might be weaker than that because they mean they got to synthesize it. So they keep with that, and sometimes they even try to level all the research that's coming because they always want to appear big. Whereas me, I can't give a shit about me. That's why I ain't got no motherfucking money. Otherwise, I'd be like, yo, man, you want me to speak out there? It's going to be $700. You know, I was $300 till 2000. Some people say that's a shame and all this kind of thing, but you got to understand. My thing is that I wasn't into it for that. I was into it for the research. So therefore, I can go further and further trying to understand and ponder those same things. But it's in certain of the Nag Hammadi library, and especially in Bentley Layton's book, there's a part in there where they talk about the original soul carries a shadow with it and stuff. Even in Blavatsky's book, there's a thing called No Shadow, No God. In one or two pages of the secret doctrines and stuff.